Hey everyone, this is Sandeep Mallya from 99signals.com and this is yet another AppSumo deal review. I've not done this in quite some time because I've really been focused on my agency, my blog, and I've been a little slow in terms of uploading videos on YouTube. So if you're a subscriber to this channel, I really apologize, and I'll be doing these AppSumo deal reviews and offering other marketing tutorials on a more regular basis in the coming weeks and coming months. With that out of the way, I would just like to talk about this AppSumo deal, Optinly. This deal has been live on AppSumo for a few months now. It's a tool that I've been using for the past few months and I've been really impressed with it. So if you don't know about Optinly, it's an email capture tool, much like OptinMonster, which is one of the leading email capture tools on the market. AppSumo itself has its own email capture tool called Sumo. And you may have used it in the past, you may have used OptinMonster in the past, or you may have used any of the other email capture tools on the market. This is very similar to that. The most interesting proposition that Optinly has right now is this AppSumo deal, where you can get lifetime access to it for just $59. Now, if you're looking for an email capture tool that's not too heavy on your pocket, then Optinly is the best choice for you right now. As long as AppSumo is offering this deal on Optinly, you can get lifetime access to all the features and templates within Optinly for just $59. Now, if you're moving over from Sumo or OptinMonster or any of the other email capture tools out there that are quite expensive when it comes to monthly subscription, these tools are not cheap, but you're looking at the same kind of features, then Optinly is probably something that you would want to go for. But right off the bat, I would like to tell you that Optinly is probably not as good as OptinMonster. I was using OptinMonster for a very long time, and when AppSumo offered this deal on Optinly, I was really curious, and I didn't think that I would be shifting to Optinly anytime soon, but it was giving me the same kind of features that OptinMonster was giving at a much lower price. Now, OptinMonster definitely has better templates. They've been in this game for a long time, so they have better looking templates. They also have better features, but I also think that Optinly is a tool that will improve over time. When I first started using this tool, there were not many templates that were available, but slowly they've added more templates. And since customization options are available to you, you can make these templates look just the way you want. Now let's compare the actual Optinly pricing with the AppSumo pricing. Now, when you look at the pricing table of Optinly, you can of course start for free. So if you'd like to test this tool out before you make an investment, you can sign up for a free account. With this, you get access to free pop-up templates. You can use these pop-ups and email capture forms to up to 2000 views a month. So that's what you can do with the Optinly's free account. And the next starter plan is $9 per month. Again, your views are restricted to 15,000 and you can just use it on a single site. And finally, you have the growth plan, which is $25 per month. It's restricted to 25,000 views per month. Now, with the AppSumo deal, I'm not aware of any such limitation. I've been using this tool for quite some time, and as far as I know, there's no restriction on the number of monthly views for your campaigns. Just to give you a glimpse, so you can see the views here for the campaigns in June, and it's well over 40,000. And to tell you honestly, I've not even used it that much this month. There are many campaigns which are not live at the moment. And you can see the total number of views is well over 350,921. And I've been using it for 3 or 4 months. And April and May were the 2 months when I was like having a lot of campaigns on my site. So as far as I know, there are no restrictions when you go with the AppSumo lifetime deal on Optinly. But if you buy Optinly directly from their website, as you can see, there is a restriction on the number of views for your campaigns. This is something that's really surprising. There's no other plan that's mentioned on their website at the time of doing this review. So maybe they'll increase the number of views, or you can simply get in touch with customer support. Because if you have a large website and you have a lot of pages, then you're easily going to exceed this limit, which is why it would be better if you go with a plan which has unlimited views per month. So that covers the pricing section of Optinly. I've compared it with what you get with AppSumo. Now let's jump into the demo of Optinly, where I'll highlight some of the key features of this tool, how you can set it up, and the kind of integrations that are available for your campaigns. So let's dive right in. Right, I've just logged into my Optinly account, and this is the dashboard. The first thing you'll notice is some analytics for the campaigns that are live. You'll also see a monthly breakup. You'll see the number of views that your campaigns have received in the current month. the clicks and the responses. Below, you'll see a list of campaigns that are live and the campaigns that have been paused. And you'll also see the analytics. You'll see the views, clicks, and responses to your campaigns. So let me quickly show you how you can set up a campaign on Optinly. From the left side menu, go to the campaign section. And here you can click on the create campaign button. And after that, you need to set your goal. If you want to build your email list, then you have to pick build audience. And if you want to promote some special offers or guide website visitors to some other page on your site, you can pick any of these options here. You also have a lot of e-commerce options. You have the reduced cart abandonment as a goal. You also have the increased cart value prompt. You have coupon pop-ups. And then you have countdown timer as well. These are all the features that you can use. You can also set up gamification pop-ups and you can also conduct surveys. Once that is done, just give it a title and then hit the create button. Now you'll get to see all the templates that you can use. And on top, you'll see the options that you have for the different email capture forms that you can use. Pop-up is the most common and they also have a lot of templates for pop-ups. The one that I like the most is the floating bar because I feel it's the most non-intrusive of the pop-ups. They also have a few sidebar templates. So depending on what your goal is and depending on how you want these email capture forms to behave with the users on your site, you can pick any of these options here. You also have the full screen pop-up, which is also called the welcome mat. So when a user lands on your website, it covers the entire page with this particular pop-up. I'm not a big fan of this because it affects the user experience on your site, but there are people who use it quite regularly. I've seen a lot of marketers using it. It's one way for you to grow your email list. So there are a few welcome mat templates that they have, which you can use. You also have the option to embed your pop-ups and you have the option to create a video pop-up as well. So like I said, based on your goal, pick any of these options and then you can start customizing your template. Now, before you start creating a campaign, there are a couple of things that you need to do. First thing you need to do is you need to integrate Optinly to your website. You can do that from the dashboard itself. You can just click on installation instructions and there are two options for you. One is you can just copy this JavaScript code into the header section of your website. So if you have an insert headers and footers plugin, you can just copy this code there. But the easiest way you can do this if you're using WordPress is simply download the Optinly plugin. You can download it here. And once you've done that, you can just upload it to your plugin directory. Once the plugin is activated, you just need to copy this code. And this will ensure that Optinly is smoothly integrated to your website. The second thing you need to do, especially if you're planning to use Optinly to grow your email list and not just promote special offers, you should integrate it with your email marketing service. The best thing is Optinly provides integrations with all the leading email marketing tools out there. To do that, just go to the integrations tab and here you'll see all the leading email marketing tools that you can integrate with Optinly. So whatever email marketing service you're using, whether it's MailChimp or ConvertKit or SendinBlue or even AppSumo SendFox, you can just integrate it right here. Right now, the primary email service that I use is MailChimp, so it's integrated here. So once your integration is complete, you'll see it in this particular column. So once your website is set up with Optinly and you've integrated your email marketing service, you can start creating your campaigns. Coming back to the campaigns now, once again, these are the templates that are available to you. The most common format that you can pick is a pop-up, and Optinly offers a lot of pop-up templates that you can customize. So I'm going to show you how I customized one of these pop-up templates. And this is the template that I used, which is called Jigsaw Guide Template. Let me just show you how I customized this pop-up and the trigger options that are available to you. So this is the pop-up that I redesigned and customized. This is where I'm just offering a lead magnet, an ebook. And I replaced the stock image that they had with the cover of my ebook. And you can do the same. You can customize the look and feel of the pop-up banner to suit your needs. To do that, you just need to hit customize. So first thing you need to enter is probably the title. Once again, you have different font options. You can present the text just the way you want. Then you need to add a description. Again, this is not mandatory. You can just skip this or you can just completely delete it. And when it comes to form, you have the option to add different fields. In this case, I added a name field and an email address field. You can add as many fields as you want. But if you're trying to grow your email list, then it's better if you just have one or two fields or just one field that is your email address field, because that's what you would probably want. And then you can customize the look and feel of your button as well. You can change the text here, and you can even set a redirect. So if someone enters their email address and hit the download now button, in my case, they can directly download the ebook. But some people prefer having just a short thank you message, and the ebook is then later sent to their email inbox. I prefer to do both. So in this case, I've just redirected this button, and then you can change the background image. So whatever stock image that's there, you can either use it or you can pick a different stock image that they have. They have a decent stock image collection, or you can upload an original image that you have. So this is how you can customize the form. You can also customize the thank you page. Like I said, I have both options. There is a short thank you message that is displayed, and then the user is redirected to this particular URL where they can download the ebook. So that's how you customize a pop-up template, and that's how you can customize any of the templates that are available on Optinly. Now let's head back to campaign settings. Next, you can tweak the settings of your pop-up and decide when you want to show your pop-up and where you want to show it. So let's just go through the display rules first. You can show your pop-up on page load. This is right at the time when someone visits your website. So as soon as the page is loaded, the visitors will see the pop-up. I wouldn't recommend this because this also leads to pogo sticking. Pogo sticking is when users switch back and forth between search engine result pages. And you wouldn't want that to happen for your site. It really affects the user experience on your site. So never show your pop-up on page load. Instead, what you can do is show your pop-up on exit. This is also called an exit intent pop-up. So right when the visitor is about to leave your website, that's when the pop-up is triggered. So for example, if I'm done with this site and I either move to the next tab or try to hit the cancel button, that's when the pop-up is triggered. So this is one of the best display options that you have, because exit intent pop-ups are the least intrusive. So when someone visits your website, they would obviously like to see what you have to offer. If it's an article, they would like to read that article without any interruptions. So it's always better to show the pop-up right when they're about to leave the website. The next option is click to trigger. So this is where you can set up a pop-up trigger for any of the images or text on your website. So the moment someone clicks on the image or the text, that's when the pop-up is loaded. The next option is show on scroll. So when you toggle this option, you'll see the scroll percent, and you can set the scroll percent. If you're going with this option, I would advise you to set it at least over 50%. So this is where a particular user has read 50% of your article or has skimmed through 50% of your article. That's when the pop-up is triggered. Once again, the goal here is to make your pop-ups as non-intrusive as possible. So this is an option that you can use. And the last option is to show it on inactivity. So you can decide the inactivity time. So suppose the user has stayed inactive, let's say for 45 seconds, that's when you can show this pop-up. So if the user has not clicked anywhere or not scrolled, they've just stayed inactive for a certain amount of time, that's when you can show this pop-up. So my recommendation would be to set the inactivity time to at least 45 seconds if you're going with this option. Next, you can choose when you want the pop-up to be shown to the same visitor. So suppose someone cancels your pop-up, they don't want to join your email list, or they don't want to see what you have to offer, and they revisit your website, you can wait for 2 days before that pop-up is shown to them. And then you have the option to show the pop-up to a subscriber. So someone who has subscribed to your email list, you wouldn't want to show them this pop-up repeatedly, right? So you can choose when you want the pop-up to reappear to the same subscriber. So by default, it's set at 365 days. I would advise you to keep it the same. And the next are the targeting rules. Now, by default, if you decide to not set the targeting rules, the pop-ups are shown everywhere on your site. Doesn't matter which page it is, whether it's a home page or your product page or your blog posts, the pop-ups are shown everywhere. This is where you can set the targeting rule. So suppose there are certain URLs where you don't want the pop-up to show up, you can ensure that the pop-up doesn't show up on those pages, just like I've done here. So I didn't want this particular pop-up to appear on certain pages, and that's what I've done. You can either copy paste the whole URL here, or you can pick certain keywords that appear in this URL. So in case you have multiple articles on the same topic, that's when you can select this option, and any URL that contains these keywords, that's where the pop-up will not be shown. Similarly, if you want the pop-up just to appear on your homepage, you can select this option, or if you want the pop-up to appear only on a specific page, that's when you can set this particular option, where only the page which is highlighted here, that's where the pop-up will be shown. So these are the URL options, which is the most common use of the targeting rules. You can also select different options. You can select page views, you can select sessions, specific countries which you want to target. You have that option as well, specific time zones, and you have referral. Let's say you get a lot of traffic from Facebook or Twitter, and you want these pop-ups to be shown only to those visitors. You can set that option here and delete the rest of the options. So that's a summary of what Optinly does. I've shown you how you can set up Optinly on your website. I've also shown you how you can customize the existing templates on Optinly. And I've also shown you the display rules and the other targeting rules that you can set up on Optinly. So that wraps up this demo of Optinly. If you're looking for an email capture tool and you like what you see here, then you can go ahead with the AppSumo lifetime deal on Optinly. So at the time of doing this video, this deal is still live, and it has been live on the AppSumo website for a very long time. So I hope you can grab this deal when it's still available. You can find a link in the description of this video. You can go ahead and check it out. Like I said at the start of this video, I was using OptinMonster and I found it to be quite expensive, and it was also slowing down my website. I don't know if you've had the same experience with OptinMonster. My core web vitals were taking a hit, so that's when I decided to go with an alternative, and luckily I found Optinly on AppSumo, and I've had a great experience using this tool so far. Based on what you have seen in this video, if you think that this email capture tool is the right fit for your current needs, then go ahead with the AppSumo lifetime deal on Optinly while it's still available. Thank you so much for watching this review and demo. I hope you found it useful, and I'll be back very soon with another AppSumo deal review.